execute Order 66.
Welcome back to the channel, everybody. It's good to have you all here. We are settling in for episode 5 of Tales of the Jedi, Practice Makes Perfect. This was more of a comedic addition to Tales of the Jedi. This certainly got me laughing a bit more than any other episode. And was just a beautiful piece of symmetry as we went through and we saw the evolution of Ahsoka and ultimately understood what Anakin was trying to do with Ahsoka each time he pushed her throughout the series. And you could even relate this as closely as season 1, where he gets her to lead the squad of clone pilots into battle during the Battle of Ryloth. So we open up with Anakin running towards the training room, and obviously they've been sort of pared down a little bit, with Anakin and Obi-Wan being made to look a little closer to their episode 2 appearances. Which is interesting, given that Ahsoka is already at the temple, and we already had episode 3 Obi-Wan's hairstyle in the Clone Wars movie, which would have taken place before this. So, a little bit confusing in terms of Obi-Wan's hair growth, but you could just say that he grew out a little bit every now and then, and every time we saw him, he just kind of, you know, pushed it to the side. But anyway, this was great, just kind of see Ahsoka in training, and one of the best parts of this moment was Kanan Jarrus was in the background. Kanan and his master Depa Bilaba were in this episode. They had no sort of vocal appearances or anything like that, but they were in the episode. Ahsoka and Kanan were training at the temple at the same time.
So beautiful.
This just adds a little bit more to Kanan and Ahsoka's relationship later down the line in Star Wars Rebels. So very happy to see this. And just a welcome little addition to the episode. They didn't need to throw it in there, but they did for the fans. And that's kind of what this series is for the fans. After the training is done in the little room that they're in, Anakin and Ahsoka talk outside. And Anakin says that these tests are weak. They won't prepare you for anything that will actually happen in battle. So he tells Ahsoka to meet him later, as he has a test lined up for her. What he actually chooses to do is uses Rex and some of the members of the 501st to fire stun shots at her that will kind of improve her senses and will help heighten her awareness when it comes to being in battle. This was great, and actually is the kind of shit that I think a lot of people wanted to see in terms of Jedi training for Ahsoka. And at the crux of it all, this does help Ahsoka by the end. They even give you that symmetry at the end, with the final moments being the moment where Rex and Ahsoka confront Jesse and the other clones after Order 66 has been enacted. In this moment, we get some very impressive visual updates for Rex and the clones. Their armor has been tailored to look a little closer to episode 2 clone trooper armor, which again is a little bit jarring given that this is after the Clone Wars movie, so we already kind of established the look of the clones at this point. But then again, this might be training gear, this might be training armor, I don't know, but there's definitely a bit of time that's passed. There's a possibility that this could be before the clones receive their phase 2 armors and everyone kind of moves, because Ahsoka's top is a little bit lower, so it's not like the sort of crop top, boot tube, whatever you call it, that she wears throughout the first 2 seasons of Clone Wars. It looks a little closer to her season 3 get up. And we get a great little comedic moment.
Yeah, Jesse really tagged you.
Sorry, Commander!
Which was, a great little parallel to literally the end of the episode where Ahsoka is confronting that exact same clone and the rest of the 501st or the 332nd that are ready to execute her. The episode is the shortest. It definitely felt the shortest of the season, but it's just kind of an understanding of Ahsoka's awareness and how her abilities developed and what Anakin did in actually almost preparing her for Order 66 in the way that she gets away. So really good stuff, and just a fun little adventure to see, you know, one of the best written Star Wars characters go on at this point. That's going to do it though, everybody. Thanks again for tuning in, and make sure to check out the rest of the videos and episode breakdowns. Until then though, take care and may the Force be with you.